welcome to Christmas Chapel. It's been an interesting week already, right? Kind of unexpected things happening, and those continue a little bit with sound, but we're excited to be able to share this with you. Our theme kind of this year, on Friday we have Christmas on campus, and so this is kind of a taste of some of the things that will happen at Christmas on campus. But we decided to kind of go with the idea of Christmas traditions. And so there's lots of traditions. When you put up the tree, right? Some people do it way early, some after Thanksgiving, others wait. Christmas movies, right? Just the other night I was watching Elf as I was doing something else. It was fun. Lots of different things. Songs and music are part of it. But most important, we want to celebrate the story of the birth of Christ. And so that's what we want to do this morning. We're going to be using some songs, and then a little bit later we're going to be using some videos to help tell the story. But right now this is just a lighthearted Christmas song that everybody knows, so just listen and enjoy.
Through the snow in one horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way long.
Christmas on Campus, which is Friday night in the Doherty Center at 7 o'clock. You'll hear some other groups like the Jazz Ensemble, who's been working on some things. We're also doing something unique. For several years, actually for 39 years, the college hosted a Madrigal Dinner. We rented a kind of a Gothic-style church in downtown Lansing, and we did a Madrigal Dinner. That stopped in 2012, but this year for Christmas on Campus, we're inviting Madrigal singers to come back, and we're going to have a Madrigal singer reunion choir. And we've got 28 coming so far. It's going to be a lot of fun. But this kind of introduces that sort of medieval Madrigal flavor. Actually, this is your chance to sing. So, why don't you stand with me? We're going to sing a medley of Christmas carols.
To the world, the light is come. nature sing, oh heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing.
New song, Elizabeth?
Oh, a little tune I can't seem to get out of my head.
Well, I wish I had your enthusiasm. Look at me. I know I said yes, and I meant it. But I also ran for the hills. Is that someone who's highly favored?
Oh, I'm so glad you came. You ran to the arms of someone who understands more than you know.
It's too much. I mean, no one believes me. My parents look at me like I've betrayed them, and I'm lying. And the townspeople look at me like I'm hiding some big secret. I know what I saw. And I know I said yes and I meant it, but is this what I said yes to?
Oh, try not to worry too much. I know from experience that the Lord has a grand way of getting us all on board with this plan. I've laughed more in these 6 months than I have in my whole life.
Well, I wish I could say the same, but Joseph isn't laughing. I mean, he's not laughing at all.
Well, maybe Joseph needs to take some advice from Zachariah. He hasn't said a thing about our situation.
Is it true? Zachariah hasn't been able to speak since you found out you were pregnant?
Isn't it wonderful?
Well, maybe that's just it. Maybe it's just... too wonderful.
If the Lord has chosen an old woman beyond her years and a young woman before her time, who are we to argue with him?
Shouldn't I feel more joyful? Because all I keep thinking is, why me?
Mary, this child has been written about hundreds of years by the prophets, and now it's coming to pass just as the Lord said it would. Oh, joy is not found in knowing why or how God does anything. The joy comes in saying yes to him when he calls.
Well, I guess I did do that.
Oh, yes, you did, my girl. We are so blessed, Mary, that the Lord is fulfilling his promises to us through us.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Don't look at me that way. I don't want to hear it. I mean it, Delilah. This whole trip is ridiculous, and you know it. Oh, how's that again? How's 90 miles with my pregnant wife for one? And you're not the smoothest ride ever. No offense. What if she starts contracting on the way? Yes. In fact, I am throwing myself a pity party, and you're invited, so stop complaining about it. I'm sorry. Okay, I don't blame you. I blame Caesar and this whole headcounting nonsense. Truth is, and I'm only telling you this, under ordinary circumstances, I would love to make the trip back to Bethlehem and see my family again, my uncles, my cousins, of course, Aunt Yael. But now... How am I supposed to explain? Mary needed an angel to explain it to her. I needed a divine dream to get it. What am I supposed to do when I get to Bethlehem, huh? Break the ice over some matzah? What is my family gonna say when they see Mary and I together, and she looks... Doesn't matter. We have to make the trip to Bethlehem because I, way, way back, am related to a king. What do you mean I don't look like I have royal blood? It's true. I'm related to a king. And she is about to give birth to a king. And... You said marry her. So I did. You said name him Jesus, so I will. You said he would be the Son of God. Your son. You are too good to us, Lord. What was impossible to believe still seems so impossible. So, girl, you will be carrying Mary, and Mary will be carrying the Son of God, and I will be carrying a lot to process. This little pity party thing stays between us, okay?
Come, thou long expected Jesus, born to set thy people free from our fears and sins. Release us, let us find our rest in thee.
Thank you. hearts, men. We can't give up.
What's the use?
They think we're crazy.
Yes, I see it, but it doesn't negate what we know and what we've seen.
Maybe we didn't see what we thought we saw.
Leo's right. The more that we talk about it, more people ask questions. It sounds unbelievable, even as words come out of our own mouths.
So let me get this straight. What we experienced on that hill was just a mistake? An apparition? Huh? Nonsense. What we saw was a fulfilled prophecy right under our noses, men. It would take more faith to imagine that we were all suffering from sleep deprivation or we all ate the same bad pot of stew than to just believe. We know what we've seen. We know what we've heard. God came near, men. Do not be afraid. That's what the angel said. That's what the bright light said. You know it. You can't forget about it. Do not be afraid. That's the story that we've been saying over and over for days. There has been weeks. If you put us in four different rooms and you interrogate us, we all have the same story.
An interrogation is exactly what's going to happen to us if Herod gets wind of this. Herod has killed for lesser things.
Y'all remember when we ran to the barn? When we ran to that barn and we saw the baby, the Messiah, the story that we've been hearing about since we were children, the story that our great-great-grandparents passed down to us, didn't we know? When we saw that baby, didn't we catch an inkling of what our mission was supposed to be? We are not just mere sheep herders. We get to tell the story, gentlemen. To repeat that a savior, that the Messiah was born in Bethlehem. The joyous announcement that is for everyone. Glory to God in heaven and peace on earth to all who believe. I believe. I cannot help but believe. Oh, come, all ye faithful. Oh, come, all ye faithful.
Oh, come, all ye faithful. Joyful and triumphant.
Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem.
Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which the Lord has made known unto us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. There came wise men from the east, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him."
Well, I've got a couple of announcements. And first of all, no, I'm not sick, but my poor wife tested positive for COVID. So out of an abundance of caution, I'm trying not to send that home with you just in case. So we got a couple of announcements. First of all, before we do this, I have a couple of prizes to give out from the survey that Ron sent out earlier, and by random drawing of people who took that survey.